Hey there, lovelies, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Sezzy Bella. Thanks for tuning in. Today's video is going to be my top must-have 5 items for my daughter with autism. These are items that I have found really helpful for her over the last couple of years, or really since she got diagnosed with autism. They are items that she has grown to love and she has found helpful herself with her day-to-day routines. I just thought I'd show them to you to see if you would like to get them for your little ones, if you've got a child that has autism or on the spectrum or with any special needs, or if you just like the items in general. I will put them in my description below if you'd like to get them for yourself. Yes, if you like this video, please like, subscribe so you don't miss out on any of my future videos, and let's get to it. So, my first item I'm going to show you today for my top must-have 5 items is her iPad case. As you're aware, in loads of my previous videos, my daughter does have an iPad for many sort of different situations. She either gets it as a reward, so if she does something that she's supposed to do, so her sensory play, some work, she eats her food, any sort of situation like that, she'll get the iPad for after. I bring the iPad out with us if we go out for the day. I mentioned in my previous video in my how I pack for 3 kids, she gets an iPad for when we go on transport. So if it's too packed or there's too many people around her, she gets very, very stressed out. So we use an iPad in that situation where she can just watch Peppa Pig or some sort of film that she likes on there, sort of zone out from the world. I do like to bring it out with us if we go out and eat, just because she's quite impatient when she waits for her food. If it takes too long, she starts to get really, really upset. But if she's able to watch something on the iPad, she sort of just zones out and she can just, you know, get into whatever she's watching, and she'll wait for her food a bit more calmly than she would if she didn't have it. Yeah, so this one I got off, I think it was eBay, I got this one, and it was £15, but you can literally get this everywhere, eBay, Amazon, I think even on the high street you can get them as well. They are absolutely amazing. My daughter loves this one because it's rubber, you can squish it up. She likes to play with this even without the iPad in it. She can bite it, she can, you know, she loves the feel of it, she absolutely loves this one. So with the iPad, it's a really, really good investment, it just to get one in general, because with iPads they do break easily, and I have had an iPad before where it just sort of drops on the floor, big crack on the screen, and the screen just eventually went. It was so annoying. I really wish I found these before. So when she does have the iPad now and she's got this on it, I know she's not going to break it. Also, when she is watching something on the iPad, suddenly she might, her emotions are very up and down, so she might suddenly just get really upset, and when she gets upset she likes to bite, and I've been a bit worried about her biting the iPad. So I know if she's got this on it, she can hold it, which is amazing. And she does need to bite. If she's not got any of her toys around her, she bites the top of this and she feels better afterwards. Biting for her, it's just a way of her communicating that she is upset, as she is non-verbal. She doesn't do it very often, but it's just precaution that she's got this on it, just so she doesn't break the iPad, she doesn't hurt herself. And yeah, she does absolutely love it though. As I said, she uses it without the iPad in it, she uses it with the iPad in it. They are absolutely amazing. I got this design of the ABCs down the side, and it's also got the numbers on the back. You can get loads of different ones. You can get more, you know, funky ones, more colourful ones, plain ones. I've seen loads and loads of different designs, so you'll always find something for your little ones gonna love. I absolutely love it. As I said, I would invest in one of these, even if you, you know, if you have an iPad, just because they do break. And I really, really do love these. They're absolutely amazing. So this has been a blessing for my daughter. As I said, so we put the iPad in it, she can hold it on the side, just more of a grip as well when she is holding the iPad, so she's not holding just the iPad by itself in case she does drop it. Don't know what else I can really say about it. She does absolutely love it. I love it as well. Really, really good buy. I would definitely recommend getting one. My next item I'm going to show you is her zippy cup. So she was on a baby bottle for ages. She didn't know how to, so after the bottle was a B cup, but she couldn't drink out of the B cup for ages. I think now thinking back on it, I think it was many different scenarios why she couldn't. You know, the from a bottle that's got a rubber top, from a beaker that's hard plastic, so sensory wise she might not have liked the jump. She didn't know how to get the drink out of the beaker. She couldn't suck it out properly, so she did stick with a bottle for ages. But she did eventually learn how to drink out of a beaker, which is absolutely amazing, and she can drink out of it now. She then learned how to drink out of sport cap bottles, so like fruit shoots, she can drink out of them really well. But she is now learning to drink out of a cup. But while learning to drink out of a cup, she is making quite a lot of spillages, as she's not 100% sure. So, you know, after you finish drinking and you put the cup back up, right, she sort of just moves her head away but leaves the cup like that's all the drink keeps pouring out. So Sky has actually got one of these with handles, as she's learning to drink out of a cup now. I thought I'd try it with Ava to see if she could drink out of it, and it's been absolutely amazing. She can drink out of it. I haven't got to worry about spillages when she moves her head away from the cup. It's a really, really good cup, I think. These sippy cups are absolutely amazing. Now, the baby loves it as well. Sky, she absolutely loves it. Ava, so she doesn't spill anywhere, because she does get quite upset when she makes spillages. She doesn't have to worry about that with this cup. She loves the colour as well. It's very vibrant, so it's very nice to look at for her. It's just a step in the right direction, because when she has learned how to, definitely, you know, she's become a pro at drinking out of this, I can move her on to the cup, and hopefully by then there won't be as much spillages. But she does absolutely love this. She can hold it properly as well. She does use the other one with handles in case she wants to hold the handles, but these I found really, really amazing. I got them both from, I think it was Sainsbury's I got these from. I think they were about £7 to £10. They were really, really good though. I was looking for Sky originally, because she was having a beaker, but I thought it's time to give her the cup now. I thought, let me try it with Ava, and she learned how to do it straight away, because I wasn't sure if she would know how to get the drink out, but she just started doing it, which was absolutely amazing. Having said that, so she does have this. I have given her a proper cup as well, just so she doesn't forget how to drink out of the cup without the protection of spilling it out. She is getting there really slowly, but I would really recommend these for little ones anyway. They're absolutely amazing to bring outside, you know, as when they're drinking, they haven't got to worry about making spillages everywhere, and they're really easy to put in the nappy bag, and I really, really love them. I don't know what else I can say about it, but I really, really do love it. I would really recommend. I'll put a link if you want to get one of these. So my next item kind of goes with the iPad case. I've shown these loads and loads of times before, but I cannot speak about these enough, her little chew toys. So she is very sensory based, meaning she likes to put things in her mouth. She likes to feel a rubber and silicone. She really, really loves these. So she has these as well as the iPad case for the same sort of situation when she's upset outside or inside. She can bite onto these, and, you know, she can easily play with these for like ages. Not just for biting, she likes to look at them as well, and because they've got different patterns and I don't know what you'd call these, different ridges, and you know, it's got different textures on them, she can feel the sides. So this one's like a tire, which she loves the feel of, and these ones got little bumps on the bottom of the key. So as well as biting, she likes to feel them as well. I have got loads of these everywhere, loads in the bathroom, in her room. And her baby sister's got one as well. No, not one, loads. They've all got loads. I've got them all around the house. I absolutely love them. But she still loves these now, so when we do go out, I do like to bring these as well as the iPad. As I said before, I don't like having the iPad too much, so I like to give her these as well. They're absolutely amazing. I think I've put links on these before, but they're like range from like £5 to £10. They're absolutely amazing. I'm so glad I found these. So when she was in nursery, the nursery actually found them first. I think they got her this one, and she really, really took to them. And then I went ahead and just bought thousands more, so she had more of a variety of them. So if I need to clean some of them, she's got loads left that she can play with. But these are really, really good. She loves the feel of them. She likes to bite them. Yeah, absolutely amazing. That is my next item for her that she absolutely loves. Comes with us everywhere. She can use them outside, use them inside. She gets a lot of enjoyment out of these. I would definitely recommend these. My next item is more of her eating routine. So I got her this plate. This one came from Sainsbury's, but I will put a link on for more that I can find online. When she eats, she doesn't like her food touching each other, and I really like these different compartments in here, so I can put different food in each bit, and they're never ever touching each other, which she really, really likes. She doesn't like it when her food touches. She won't mix her food up. Say if I put like a banana in here, yogurt, a sandwich and crisps, she eats one at a time. She won't sort of mix it up. So I have found this plate really, really helpful, because before I did get this one, I have got more of these at home, but before I just got like plain sort of, so I'd go to the Disney shop, they got loads of cute plates in there, or I'd get some plates from the supermarket, you know, just kiddie friendly plates. But I did notice that she didn't like her food touching each other. So I went ahead and had a look online, and then one day I went to Sainsbury's, and I think it was in the summertime, and it was in the barbecue range, and I found this plate, which I think is just to put like, you know, different food in it when you're having a barbecue outside. But she absolutely loves this plate. She knows this plate is her lunch plate, so when it's lunchtime, she goes into the kitchen and she picks up this plate. This plate will indicate to mummy that, you know, Ava's hungry, it's time for lunch. Which I think is really sweet as well. It's her way of talking to me, a way of communicating, as she is non-verbal. But these plates are really, really good. I absolutely love it. Even, you know, not just for the kids, but even just to have at parties and stuff to put all different food in. But I do use this one for Ava when she does eat, as she doesn't like her food touching. I love it. Definitely recommend it for anyone. My last item for her is for her communicating. As she is non-verbal, she likes to use objects and cards. That's how she talks to mummy. So, for instance, with the objects, say she wants a drink, she will go into the kitchen and she will grab her beaker and give it to mummy, and that says, "Mummy, I'm thirsty, I want a drink." Or she can go and get a toy, and then she'll say, that's her saying to me, "Mummy, it's time to play, let's play." We also have cards, so I can show her what's coming next during the day, or if we're going outside, I can show her what we're doing outside. So for instance, this one's drink. So if I want to offer her a drink and I don't want to, I can show her the beaker and I can show her the card and say, "Ava, drink," and she'll either grab the beaker to say yes, she does want it, or if she doesn't want it, she'll push it away. So if it's meal time, I can show her that it's lunch time or dinner time, breakfast time, and she knows it's time to eat. So if I want her to sit down for any reason, watch TV, read with mummy, eating, I can show her it's time to sit. If something's finished now, or I want her to stop what she's doing, I can show her the stop one. She also has, so I'm in the middle of potty training her at the moment, it's not going very well, different video, but she does have a toilet card. She has, so if I want her to listen to me, she has her listen card. And if an activity is finished or we're moving on to the next thing, she has her finish card. We have loads and loads of different kinds of cards. So if she wants her chew toy, it's her fidget toy card. Or if I want her to read with mummy, book card. She's got so many different cards, I could literally show you all of them. I won't, but we do have loads and loads of cards. I'll show you one more. If I want to do some drawing with her, show her the drawing card. She also has a now and next board, which is this, which I like to use with the cards as well, because when I am communicating with her, what I like to do, so it's simple communication with her with an object or with a card. So with this now and next board, I can show her, so say, you know, now it's time for lunch, and then next after lunch we can play with our fidget toys. This is a very new thing now and next board. We're still getting to grips with it, but she's starting to understand it now. And yeah, so she knows what the now and next board is, and she's sort of understanding, but we're getting there. But these cards I have found really, really helpful. So it's either a card with an object with simple language, or just a card or just an object with the simple language. But that is how we are communicating with her. We have been using these ever since she got diagnosed with autism, and she has been non-verbal and is still non-verbal, and it's just a way of me being able to communicate with her, and she has taken to it so well. So if she doesn't end up speaking, cards, objects and simple language will always work, as we have started so young, and now she's six. So she understands it. And that is all of my things I wanted to show you. The cards as well are very, very easy to make. We have at home a laminate machine, and it's just paper, and we do it on the, what's it called? Paint online. So we'll do it and then we'll print it, and then we'll put on the laminate machine and it will laminate it for us, or we can get it done at her school. So she has thousands and thousands of cards. She also has cards that are more personal to her, so if it's meal time, lunch time, we have a picture of her plate, or if it's drink time, a picture of her cup, or hairbrushing time, she has a picture of her hairbrush, and so on so on. So it's very personal to her, so she knows it's her things. But either cards, the personal ones, or just the ones that I just put away, or just these simple ones, she knows they're for her, she knows what they mean. And that is all of my objects, my five top must have objects for my daughter. I hope you liked them. I will put a link in the description for all of them if you want to have a look for yourself, for your little ones. I have found them really, really useful. She has got loads of different things that I could show you. That was just the five must things I wanted to show you today. I hope you enjoyed my video. Again, if you do want to check the items out for yourself, look in my description. I will put loads of links to loads of different ones that I can find online for you. And yeah, I hope you like the video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.